Hi guys, this is Navdeep Singh Jitla. Welcome to my channel. I'm an immigration law researcher and I do study cases and try to find out reasons why those were rejected, and I also would like to share that information with you so that you can prevent so many rejections, perhaps while applying for yourself or for your family. All right, so let's study this case today. This is a case whereby the applicant Mei Rong Liu from China, she applied for a work permit as a nanny. She got an offer from Canada. The employer was a single mother who wanted to hire her, and the application got rejected. We will study how and why, what went wrong, and we'll see what happened in this. So the applicant is a citizen of China. She was employed as a comprehensive support assistant for a mobile communication company in China from August 2003 until to 2017. From May 2017 to January 2018, approximately for 6 months, or approximately 6 to 7 months, 8 months, the applicant was a student at Success Solutions Career Training School in China, where she received a diploma as an in-home caregiver. So the applicant worked as a nanny in China in January 2018. On around January 2018, the applicant made her TRV application through consul. The application indicated that her proposed employment was a 2-year contract as a live-in caregiver at a home of Ms. Sun Liang in Vancouver. So the applicant included evidence of the applicant's educational qualifications. This included a proof of her completion of a bachelor's level degree plus completion of 6-month certificate as a nanny, and which included successful completion of 300 hours of hands-on training as a kindergarten caregiver, which was completed from June 2012 to June 2017. So the application also provided that the applicant had in the past compiled with the Canadian and foreign immigration requirements, because the applicant submitted a copy of Canadian multiple entry TRV that had been issued to her for an almost 7-year period. She also included passport stamps showing previous return trips from China to Canada in September 2016 and 2017. She basically demonstrated that okay, she compiled with the requirements. So the prospective employer is a single mother, as I mentioned, with a 10-year-old child who requires assistance of a caregiver to work between the hours of 7 a.m. to 11 a.m. and from 3 p.m. until 7 from Monday to Friday. So the contract sets out a fairly clear schedule for caregiver, which would involve her providing before and after care for the child, plus some additional work during school hours to handle light housekeeping and meal preparation as well. So this is key here. The applicant included a copy of prospective employer's 2016 notice of assessment, which showed Canadian employment income of over 30,000 Canadian dollars, plus a statement of account from the prospective employer's Bank of Montreal account showing that the prospective employer had a balance of over 300,000 Canadian dollars. So on December 2017, Service Canada informed the applicant's prospective employer, Ms. Liang, that Employment and Social Development Canada, ESTC, determined that her labor market impact assessment application met the requirements of the temporary foreign worker program. So on around March 2018, the officer refused the application of TRV application, and the visa officer was not satisfied. The visa officer concluded that principal applicant, this is key here, the principal applicant is requesting work permit with LMIA as an in-home caregiver, PA's daughter, which means principal applicant's daughter holds a student permit in Canada already. I have concerns, that is number one, that's okay, but I have concerns that employers SIC financial ability to pay principal applicant. Why? The NOA, notice of assessment submitted, showing low income. I note that a BMO, Bank of Montreal, statement showing a large amount of funds. It is unknown where these funds come from and if they are still there. So principal applicant recently entered this employment history. I am not satisfied that this is a genuine employment offer. Well, visa officer, I think, looked at so many factors here. The financial factor of the prospective employer is okay. The employer must have submitted some additional documents, or maybe the showing the, you know, the affidavit from where that amount had come from, or he could have also submitted the latest statement as possible. But I think the affidavit of the substantiating that where that amount had come would have, you know, made things much more easier for the visa officer. That's number one. Secondly, there are other factors which visa officer pondered upon, and I think taking a decision based on the all other factors could be tricky, because the applicant was actually meeting all the requirements. But yes, if we talk about the employer's ability, he could be yes or no. Let's see what happened. So visa officer has denied the application, but applicant has challenged the application, the visa officer's decision, that he has not taken the decision based on any rationality. He raised some concerns and the application was allowed. An application, the court ordered the application for reconsideration. He ordered the other officer to have a look on the same, and just let's see what happens. But the point is, there were some of the flaws, I would say. Number one, the affidavit was not there because there was a huge influx of amount. The affidavit should be there. I mean, it will always raise a concern for anybody. So it will be great if you always try to substantiate everything on papers, because there hardly interviews happen. In a very rare case, usually it doesn't happen, they just simply reject it. So it's very important, whatever the factors are, just make sure everything is there on the paper, and papers are actually presenting your entire case almost like a genuine, right? So it's very important. So the learnings are, as we already mentioned, as we already discussed as well at the length. So it was good to be with you, and I'm enjoying this job here, discussing everything and just letting you guys also know. And I look forward to your comments as well, and your suggestions also. So thank you so much for today, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day. Bye bye.